Good morning all. Today we'll discuss on fluid mechanics and the topic is minor losses. Okay. So coming to the topic, the minor losses. This is different types of losses are there in minor loss. Okay. In major loss only due to fixer, but in minor loss there are many types of losses. When water flows in a pipe, it experiences the small some resistance in the motion due to which the velocity is ultimately head due to the water available is reduced. That is known as the loss of head due to that pipe. So you can see here the summarize the major and minor losses. Okay, the major and minor losses and the total head loss. The total head loss is the summation of nothing but minor loss and major loss. Major loss and minor loss. Okay, and in major loss it is divided only due to the wall friction. Due to the wall friction. But in minor losses there are some other issues, that is due to sudden expansion, sudden contraction, due to fitting and due to bending, due to the entrance, due to the at the exit of pipe. Many things are there in minor losses. But in major loss, that is most important and very crucial head loss, that is the due to the friction. And in head loss due to the friction, the Darcy Weisbach equation we are going to follow. And that is already we have discussed, that is HF is equal to FL V square by 2GD. In this experiment, you will find the friction factor for various pipes. For various pipes means different pipes will get different types of friction factor value. Okay. So, but in this minor loss, the basic equation, this is not the equation for all, but this is the basic equation where we'll take the loss of head coefficient is there, that is capital K, and that formula is HLM means the minor loss, that is K V square by 2G, and here K is different for different losses, means head loss due to expansion, head loss due to contraction, that K should be there. Okay, and for short pipe, this is the important point, the short pipe with multiple fittings, the minor losses are no longer minor. Okay, understood or not? This for short pipes with multiple fittings, if there is multiple fittings, then that is not considerable for minor losses. Okay, and these are the minor losses which are the already I have told before, but I want to recall again: loss head due to sudden enlargement, loss of head due to sudden contraction, then obstruction in the pipe, head loss at entrance of the pipe, head loss at the exit of the pipe, head loss due to bend of the pipe, and head loss at various pipe fittings. Okay, different pipe fittings should have different minor losses. So losses may not be so minor. Okay, the losses may not be so minor. A partial closed valve can cause a greater pressure drop than a long pipe. What it says? It says the losses may not be so minor, because in every time if you are saying that minor losses means that is not that much minor. There should be some loss which is you have to reconsider when you are designing the pipe flow or any pipe you are going to design, means the minor losses should be taken into consideration. Okay, and the data, especially the for values, are somewhat dependent upon the particular manufacturing design. It depends upon the manufacturing design, as I told before, because the pipe fittings or the different pipes have different values. Okay, and different values means suppose you are going to take one mild steel pipe, then the friction loss should be different. But for PVC pipe or plastic pipe, the friction loss and the friction value should be different. So it depends upon the manufacturing design as well. So these are some figures. Okay, you can see the in the picturization form, that is the sudden enlargement. See, here is the pipe, here it is the pipe, and another pipe is there. Okay, and this is one diameter and this is another diameter, D1 and D2. Okay, and this is the enlargement which called as sudden enlargement, because the pipe is a smaller diameter, suddenly the larger pipe diameter is there, so there is some head loss. Okay, and when it is contraction, means here you can see this is sudden due to contraction because the larger diameter then smaller diameter. So the basic difference in between the two things, that is sudden enlargement and sudden contraction, is the smaller diameter then larger diameter. In contraction, larger diameter then smaller diameter. And here you can say this is the vena contracta point where the flow is minimum and the flow section is very minimal. In Bernoulli's equation, venturi meter, you can remember the venturi meter, the vena contracta is there where you will get very small cross section area. So here you will get the vena contracta thing, okay. And this is due to the pipe bend. See, there is some bend and this bend is also different. 90 degree bend, 45 degree bend, 30 degree bend, 60 degree bend, there are different types of bend. In 90 degree bend, if there is some loss, then in 30 degree bend pipe also the loss is different. So it depends on the different types of bend also. And here it is due to the obstruction of pipe. Suppose there is a pipe flow and in between you will get some obstruction. There should be some losses and that is under minor losses. See, there is some examples of pipe fitting. See, the pipe fitting, this is the straight fitting and there is some sudden enlargement, non sudden contraction, you can see fitting, and this is the T fitting. So one pipe is there, another pipe is there, another pipe is there. So this, suppose in three directional pipes we are fitting, so we can use this T type of fitting we can use. And suppose there are four directional pipe, in every direction if the pipe is going, suppose one fitting is required, so you can use this. Okay, so this type of fitting you can use, and these are the different types of fitting as per the requirement we can use. So there are some different types of bend, as I told here. Different types of bend, it depends upon the values. As k, the minor losses, the k into b square by 2c is there na. So the k is different for different types of bend. So here you can see this is 90 degree smooth bend, means there is not sharp edge at the bend, but here you can see 90 degree meter bend, means that the sharp bend. So here you can get the k value is more than this, because this is the smooth one and this is the 90 degree one. So here you can get more loss than this type of bend. And here some bend is there, and another 45 degree bend, okay, T bend, okay, and this is a 180 degree return bend, means this type of flow is going, then again this type of flow, means where we will use this one, suppose one way is there and there is some obstructions, we can't give the pipe bend that, so we have to divert that pipe and we can use this type of bend, then we can go for some distance, then we have to divert the pipe. So this type of pipe fitting will be required at that position. Okay, so this is all fittings are fitted in a water supply system. So you can see here every system is there. So this is the reservoir, then 90 degree bend, and this is the T bend, then this is pump, every bend you can see. So some of the bend here they are using, and this is the pipe bend. Okay, and this is some formula due to sudden contraction, sudden expansion, obstacle in pipe, and pipe bend in the fitting, and bend in pipe. There are different types of formula you are going to use, and we will describe this one by one. And a very important formula is sudden contraction and sudden enlargement or sudden expansion. All the formulas are not that much important for description purposes. So only you will cover due to the sudden enlargement and sudden contraction the equations with briefly, and other things only you will have to remember. So the loss here due to sudden enlargement. So this, in this we will give one example. So this is a pipe fitting, okay, this is a pipe fitting, and this pipe is at inlet pipe is smaller diameter and outlet pipe is larger diameter. So here you can see the flow is going on, the flow is going on, and here some eddy formation is at there, and at the outlet of the pipe, the section 22, see there is the flow is enlarging, the flow is enlarging, and here this is the junction of the pipe, junction of the two pipe, and after that enlargement is occurring. So Here A1 is area of the pipe at section 1-1 and A2 is area at pipe section 2-2. Okay, and here pi by 4 d1 square, that is d1 is the diameter of the pipe at section 1-1. Then P1, that is the intensity of pressure at section 1-1. Here you can see P1, A1, V1, D1, A1. Means all the things is coming for section 1-1. Where it is coming? P2, A2, V2, D2, A2. That is for section 2. For easy remember, we divided into 1 and 2. And there is some eddy formation due to that 90 degree position. Some eddy formations are there. Means that flow is stuck here. That is not going away. Okay. And applying the boundary situation at section 1-1 and section 2-2, we can see P1 by W plus V1 square by 2G plus Z1 is equal to P2 by W plus V2 square by 2G plus Z2 and head loss due to certain enlargement, that is HE. See? So when we are considering certain enlargement loss, that should be on the exit of the pipe. So we can see Z is equal to Z2 when the pipe is horizontal. If the pipe is inclined, this Z1 and Z2 value should be different. But when the pipe is purely horizontal, then the Z1 should be equal to Z2. Okay, so P1 by W plus V1 square by 2G is equal to P2 by W plus V square by 2G plus HE is equal to, when you will get HE is equal to P1 by W minus P2 W plus V1 square by 2G minus V2 square by 2G. So finally we will get HE is equal to this formula. And finally we will get when the force acting on the liquid in the controlled volume between the section 1 and section 2. How it is controlled volume means we are considering a specific section at section 1 to section 2. And that is called as the force acting at the liquid. Okay, at the control volume, that is P1 into A1 plus, that is the intensity of pressure, means P0 A2 minus A1 minus P2 into A2. Okay, and this is due to at inlet section, this is at section 2-2, and this is due to the eddy formation. So that is some pressure is there. Okay, so P0 is similar to P1. P0 is similar to P1. So we have again, if you will modify that equation, then P1 into A1 plus P1 A2 minus A1 minus P2 A2. So finally we get this equation Fx. Fx means force along the longitudinal direction will be P1 A2 minus P2 A2 is equal to P1 minus P2 whole into A2. Means here you can see in this formula A2 is only considerable, okay, at the area at enlargement section only considerable. Okay, so the momentum equation, from the momentum equation, mass into velocity, mass into velocity, that is the momentum equation. And what it says, it says the mass is rho AB and velocity is V1. So finally we will get rho A1 V1 square. And finally we will get the formula, change in momentum at the liquid is the section 2, the momentum at section 2 minus momentum at section 1. Okay, then by deriving the each term and each equation, we will get finally the certain enlargement equation, that is V1 minus V2 square by 2G. V1 minus V2 square by 2G. Like this, the certain contraction is there. And due to certain contraction, the vena contracta only will come. That is the only difference with certain enlargement and certain contraction. The BC will come only, and we have to take that BC term here. Okay. Then finally, we will get the certain contraction formula, that is 0.5 V2 square by 2G. Here, K is 0.5. Okay. And other minor losses are head loss due to entrance at the pipe, that is also K is same, 0.5 V1 V2 square by 2G. And everywhere you can see the K value is varying due to the head loss, due to the different region, the K value is varying. Here K value is 1 due to exit at the pipe. And due to obstruction of the pipe, the value is like this: A by CC A minus A in square means K is the this value, B square by 2G. Okay, and these are the all the about the minor losses, and this is the fitting K by B square by 2G. Okay, and this is all about the minor losses. So thanks for the attending. If you have any question, you can ask me. Okay, thank you.